Hello, this is Liz with Crafty Devotion, and I decided to bring it in while I'm creating this project. I've already started my project, and I decided I was going to make a wall hanging. I don't think I've ever made a wall hanging. I've made other things, but never wall hangings. And I tried sharing this on YouTube Live, but my connection was really bad, so I'm sorry. Those who were there for me, there were about 3 people that showed up, which being a test, and I still haven't gotten it, but I did learn that YouTube allows you to have YouTube Live, so I may start scheduling it, but maybe during the day. So, and I have to test it again because to see if it will record better in a different room, because the Wi-Fi connection, the internet connection, kept on going off. But anyways, I began this project with a piece of canvas fabric. And then I placed a piece of a thin fabric lace over that. And I haven't really glued it all down because I'm going to be gluing in different areas. And this is going to be a layered piece. And this image here, I have actually purchased these. And these were fabric images like for quilting. And I have been buying those and putting those in my store. And that's why I got these. I thought I'd put them in my store, my shop. And then I thought, well, maybe I should make a kit or something. But I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to accomplish the kit because I have to order more laces for that purpose. But I might put like a partial kit together where I give you, you know, this and some laces that I've tea-dyed, and then you can add to it from your stash type of a thing. But these are the images that I have, and there's 4 of them. And I just measured it when I was on YouTube, and it was about 5 by 4.5 or something like that. They're not very large, so I'm thinking of making like a collage of photos I can put on one wall, is what I'm thinking. And I started that, and then I'm going to be layering. I don't do a lot of layering, but I am going to be layering on this one. And what I put so far is I've put a layer of this. I showed you that. And then this right here is actually, I had this wide, it's a stretchy lace that I actually avocado dyed. So this is an avocado, so it's a very light rosy pink. And I'm going to use the mostly dyed fabrics in. And I'm pretty sure I know what I'm going to do, because I was kind of setting it up and saying, what can I do? What would work? And I wanted to use some of the items that I've been using in my my tutorial for my new series on doily. I've been deconstructing doilies in my new series, and I wanted to use some of those items. And then I wanted to use just some tea dyed items that I have. So this piece is a synthetic that I tea dyed, and actually it does work to dye some synthetics, and some do not work. And this is a dangle that's going to be the bottom. This piece here is a piece that on my doily tutorial I showed you how to create lace with a doily. So this is an actual doily that I turned into lace, and I'm thinking I was not gonna use all of it like a frame. I guess it could be a frame. Let's see, I could make it a frame, but I don't think I am. I think I'm gonna go like maybe part way up. Not sure. Don't know if, I don't think so. Maybe I'll keep it down here. I think I'll put it just down below. That's gonna be gonna work. I can use the other pieces in a different way. So this just came out gorgeous, gorgeous. I just love the way this lace came out. And it, like I said, it is a vintage doily that I deconstructed, and I showed you how I deconstructed it on my YouTube channel. I have a new series up called Doily Deconstruction. And so I was thinking of doing this, and I want both of these to be here. Yes. And then I was going to place something on top of it. Oh, yes. Thinking these. And I love the color that this came out. This one is a doily that was actually, this part of it was actually white that I tea-dyed different colors. So I love the colors, and I think it's bringing in that it's matching well with the parts that are avocado dyed. So this is avocado dyed here, and this one is dyed with Rit dye, and I decided I wanted to use it in a project. It came out so gorgeous, and I'm really frugal when it comes to my doilies and my laces. I don't like to waste them, so you'll find that in me. So, and then I had planned to possibly place either this here, and I have something else I could use this, but I think I'm going to use this. I like the pink. It's like a very rosy pink. It goes well with the, I'm trying to decide if I want to put it here. Like here, because I do love the colors. I'm afraid it'll, I'm going to hold it up and see what will happen with the dangles. I think they'll lie very well. So I'm going to show, even though it looks a little tattery, this part, I want to keep it. I like the color. I like the look. So you're here watching me make my very first wall hanging, and something I had never really done. And when I layer things, I have in my way of doing it is that I like to show like everything to show. Like I want there to, I don't like cover everything up most of the time. Let's see. So I want a little bit of it to show. That's just the way I design and I create. Yeah, that looks nice. I like that. So, then this one here. Now, this is a piece of lace that, of ribbon trim that I got. And I actually I put these in some de-stash bags that I placed in my shop. A piece of synthetic dye that I lace that I tea dyed, and so I had been thinking about placing it like that, or I could place it this way. I like it the other way. I think I like it like that, and this one did not dye very well, but it did take the avocado dye. So some laces that you dye, especially if they're synthetic, won't take the dyes very well. And I'm just gonna let that dangle down, I think. Just glue the flowers. This is nice. Okay, what do you think so far? That look gorgeous. Okay, so this is using, like I said, this is a dyed doily that I took apart, and I still have to trim this up a little bit. I'm thinking I'm gonna move this over and glue this along here. I actually think that's pretty, and I love the colors. And basically, everyone is asking me, oh, are you going to do tutorials on dyeing laces? Well, let me tell you, it did take me a long time to dye the laces. I put a lot of them in my shop, and pretty much it depends for me on how busy I am, in my shop. So the best way for things to happen is for you to share, my tutorials, to share my YouTube channel. And this piece right here is, I have actually sets in my shop, and this one's tea dyed and this one's avocado dyed. And you can see how this one actually, I think, has some tea dyeing in it and avocado dye and a synthetic dye on it. It was dyed in layers. So I'm thinking I think I'm going to make it into a bow. So this looks pretty so far. What do you think?
I like it. This is
a piece from one. It actually might even be a piece of this one, but I'm not sure. It's from one of the ones that I deconstructed in the tutorial. And it's actually coming apart in a few places, so I'm going to use it. I think I'm going to place a flower on this end here. Let's see what else I find. And then I'm going to lie some things up here just to see if I like how they look with the coloring. These are actually some small doilies that I purchased. I was thinking about dyeing them to see if they would kind of give a more vintage look to them, but I do like the colors, and since he's wearing blue, I might use them. I don't know. Here's a flower that we made on my new series with the doily. I was going to use that. And I know there's other things. What I've been doing is taking pieces of just different tea dyed items, colors. Like, I think this will look gorgeous. Little snippets here and there. Here's another one. I was thinking of putting this one. This one looked cute up here or along the side. I was thinking of putting it up along the side here and then placing one of these, something like that. Maybe, we'll see. This is a piece of tea dyed, no, it's avocado dyed that went in my vintage kit when I made a vintage crafty box. That's what that is. And I had some of this, right? I was thinking I might put this on. So when I'm designing, I do all kinds of things that I bring out things that I think will go, and then I kind of just play around with them, make some decisions. I'm looking to see how much this is, if I could use it in a different, in another wall hanging, or can I, should I cut it in pieces? I have this gorgeous copper. This is a vintage piece of a sheer, like, organza feeling fabric, and it has like these ruffles in it, and I was thinking I liked the way it goes. It kind of brings in some of the almost like a pinky copper color. I think I'm going to turn this one into a rose so I can put it along with these, and I don't know. Hopefully you guys know how to make roses, but you can watch me. Better put some glue before it. comes apart. Sometimes working with organza is kind of afraid that I'm going to burn my fingers. I don't know, it's about 1.5 inches wide. I had a copper green one. I kind of liked it too because, let me show it to you. But I didn't have that big of a piece. I probably could get another one, but you know, I use what I have on hand. So I could make this flower and not use it, and that would be okay. So I don't know if I'm going to turn this into a process video. It's a good size right there. I'm going to just trim it off if I can get my scissors. What do you think of that color, huh? This one is actually, I did a tutorial on how to make this one. It was with this one, except this one I actually had tea dyed it. And I had, you can see the color of the tea dye on it, where this one's all white. This one was tea dyed, and I had cut it shorter because I was going to use it standing up in a certain project. So that's what I was thinking of doing here. Not sure if I want that cluster there. Maybe I should put it on the bottom here and just leave that. I think something like that. Let's get this tassel over here. Oh, I think I'm just going to attach it to the back of the flower. Is there a top or a bottom to this flower? I think this should be the bottom here. So we'll go this way. I didn't cut this specifically for this purpose, so it kind of is scraggly, but that's what I wanted. I want scraggly. I feel like I need to bring a little bit of green into the picture. Maybe I'll put this in the back. So this type of dangles, I can always trim them again after if I leave them a little long. I'm pretty sure if I use the scissors on this, I'll make it, it'll twist. Yeah, look how well it twisted. Wow, a little more than I thought. Do that one a little lighter. That's interesting. Look how pretty that is. But I think I'm going to put it in the back.